grief is such a complex and unique experience for everyone. I've heard the word storm used, but then that doesn't account for the more peaceful aspects. I think it's just there's a shattering that makes sense to me, and I was very inspired by the writings of Peter Maris, an English sociologist who wrote a book called Loss and Change in 1974. So that was when I was, I guess, first studying social work in those early years. And he said that bereavement shatters the structure of meaning that makes the world intelligible, and it sort of breaks the thread of continuity. So I think these ideas of shattering and brokenness make the most sense to me when we talk about grief, not so much, you know, the anger phase or the guilt phase. And I've actually been using that again in turning fragments of broken glass. I live near a glass blowing factory, fortunately. So there are all these fragments that are available because things break. Beautiful plates, vases, and they're all different colours and shapes. And they go back into the kiln as fragments, and because they've got sharp edges, so they have to be sort of molten to be safe with the soft edges. So I think the softening of the edges is a really powerful sort of metaphor. Tearing of the fabric and then the repairing of the fabric is probably my favourite metaphor. There'll always be something different about the fabric. If someone's died, or you've moved to another country, or you've lost a job that was important to you, whatever the grieving experience is about, you'll never get back exactly the same situation or personal relationship, will you? You'll always have, something will be different in the new configuration, the new pattern.